Hey, what's up, guys? This is Junebug, and I am bringing you another advanced character guide. This time, I'm joined by a good friend, Gallo.
Hey, what's up, guys? Glad to be here.
Yeah, since I don't know that much about Mario, Gallo's gonna be teaching you guys a lot of stuff. But let's start out with some of the basics.
Alright, guys, so the good things about Mario are that he's super simple to pick up. It's great if you want to pick him up as a new player, because compared to all the characters, he doesn't have that many advanced techniques to learn, and his skill floor is very low. So you should be able to pick him up and right away start performing decently well in tournaments. He's known for being kind of a noob slayer, people would call him. He's middleweight, so he won't die too early from most attacks, but he also won't be comboed too hard because he's pretty floaty. So in general, his weight's very good for new players, so you won't get comboed to death too easily, and you won't also die too easily from smash attacks. He has got one of the best projectiles in the game. Fireballs are super good for just controlling space, and the angle on them is like very hard sometimes for opponents to get through. So it forces shields a lot, which is good as long as they're not power shielding them. And you could get opponents into sticky situations that way and cross them up with them. It's good because you could also have two out at a time. And you could have two out at different angles coming.
And we'll get more into that in the mix-up section.
He has a great crouch cancel game. Crouch canceling into down smash is a big one. Crouch cancel into down tilt could start combos. And crouch cancel into forward tilt is fine too, if you need to get people off.
Alright, so those are some of the reasons why Mario's pretty good. But, I mean, he does have his weaknesses. One of his cons is that he himself is susceptible to crouch canceling. So, like, a lot of what Mario's normal is, well, right now...
You can still crouch cancel down tilt, dude. That's how hard he gets crouched.
Yeah, like, his forward tilt, his up tilt, a lot of his moves just kind of lose to crouch canceling. At lower percents, especially, and even those higher percents, like I'm not getting a knock up off this down tilt because he's crouch canceling. So yeah, definitely watch out for crouch cancels if you're a Mario player. Another thing to look out for is like linear approaches, like because Mario's fireball is so good, and like all of his aerials are really solid. A lot of Mario's just kind of fall into this habit where they approach with the same thing over and over again, whether it be like fireball or short hop nair. And while Mario does have a lot of good approaches, you can't become too predictable with them, especially when he doesn't really have like the range or the speed of a Spacey or Diddy Kong to just like spam a ton of aerials. Speaking of range, it's not that big. Like definitely pretty average in terms of other characters.
Yeah, it's actually on the lower side for sure of range. He doesn't have too many disjoints, even down air, as opposed to 3.0 version where it was like the best move of all time. Now it actually matches the feet. So all of his moves, like, they're good, they're super quick, but the problem is they don't have too much range on them. So most characters, the way they beat Mario is by walling him out.
Mm-hmm. So you definitely have to learn how to space your normal as well if you're playing Mario, because you don't have the luxury of hiding behind disjoint. And while he's a middleweight, he doesn't have the best landing options. You can mix up your landing in several ways, but if you're getting juggled up here, it's going to be a struggle coming down. Yeah, and a last kind of con is he has a really short grab range. Like, wow, he grabbed my hands! Yeah, so while you do want to get a lot of grabs, because a lot of your combos start from grab,
Down throw, especially on most characters.
It does have a short range, so you definitely have to be wary of that.
Yeah, it's bottom five in the game, actually.
Let's talk about Mario's main tools in the neutral, in terms of like his movement and his moveset.
Okay, so even though Mario's run speed isn't the greatest, it's pretty average. His wave dash makes up for it, more than makes up for it. Wave dash and waveland lane is super good, especially at a shield. So what you want to do is sometimes use it as a way to get in or to get out of pressure. And you can use it after fireballs too. You could use it really good to mix them in with wavelands on platforms. And crossing up your opponent too, you could get.
Yeah. So definitely a really good wave dash use to disengage. In terms of like his good approaches, his number one approach is probably fireball.
Fireball is usually what you want to be doing to just start your pressure, because it's gonna force your opponent to do something no matter what.
Mm-hmm. I call it the Akuma. For those of you who watch Street Fighter, you know Akuma likes to come in with that fireball. And what that fireball allows him to do, it just basically gives you a free mix-up on your opponent's block. And that's really good for Mario, because he has some good things he can do on block. We'll talk about that later.
So
but
when you're throwing fireballs, you also can obviously approach with something else as well. Mm-hmm. My favorite thing to do is throwing fireballs and nairing, because it's a lot for your opponents to deal with in general, because mm-hmm. There's hitboxes coming at them from two different ways, and nair is a long-lasting hitbox. Mm-hmm. Sex kick. But you could also mix in up airs, fireball to down smashes.
And, yeah.
In other things that we've learned, is approaching with fair, which is the Junebug now, apparently.
Yeah, if I played Mario, I would just do this.
It's got a lot of shield stun, so if you do hit shield, your opponent's not really going to be able to punish.
Yeah.
And it's so strong that sometimes it'll just straight up kill if they're at 100%.
So, definitely when you're shooting fireballs, look out for what your opponent likes to do out of shield. For example, if I shot a fireball and Gallo likes to wave dash forward out of shield, then maybe I'd nair. But if he wanted to wave dash back, I'd do a later nair. So, keep in mind what your opponent is doing out of shield when throwing your fireballs. And this, I guess this kind of ties into offensive mix-ups, so we should get into that. When you're mixing up your opponent's shield, there's a few different things you can do. One is jab.
Mm-hmm. His jabs are really good because you could, since his moves are so quick, you could like jab to down tilt or jab to down smash, which is the classic. And jab and down tilt pressure will really get people's shield to really low, dangerously low percents. And then if you shield poke with down tilts, usually we'll get that shield poke. It will usually combo into forward.
Mm-hmm.
As and, long as they're not DIing away.
Jab grab is pretty good. You also want to be paying attention to if they're crouch canceling, because if they start crouch cancel grabbing or doing stuff, then a lot of your jab pressure isn't going to work. So you have to go for more jab down smash or stuff like that. And down smash is super quick, and it's pretty hard to I think you can punish it on shield.
You can.
But I don't think you can punish it if you crouch cancel it.
Right. Cuz if you crouch cancel it, but as of 3.6, you can crouch cancel. You can punish it out of shield because it's not as strong as it used to be.
So jab tilt is pretty good. Jab even like dash away. That's the boss. Like, he just jabs you, and then he stops, he just does nothing.
The boss is the father of Mario, for sure.
Shoutouts to Grandpa Boss. I'll tag him in the... when I post this to Twitter.
Word.
But yeah. Jab's pretty good. If you notice they're just shielding fireballs, you can just straight grab... Oh my god, that was so quick. You can just straight grab them. You notice them shielding after... Oh my god. After your fireball. You can just go for straight jab. You can come down with an aerial. Oh, I did too high. You can come down with an aerial to depending on where they are. But yeah, shuffle aerials are also really good. We talked about Nair because that's his main approach and somewhat fair, but all of his aerials are kind of good on shield.
Yeah, they're also like, super quick and they don't have much end lag. That's why that's like the main strength of Mario in the air, I would say.
Like a good shuffle back air, shuffle up air.
Yeah, you want to space those bears for sure.
Any of his aerials on shield are going to give you a good mix-up. Bear is a lot safer. Rather than like going in with jabs or tilts afterwards, you just want to kind of keep spacing and notice how they're moving out of shield. This is called the Seagull Joe in MDVA.
Space bears?
Yeah, just bears.
Pretty
this
sure
is what...
I think of it as just the brawl.
Well, Joe was a brawl player, so is that...
All right, so
that's pretty much it when it comes to offensive mix-ups with Mario. Definitely keep in mind your aerial pressure, your jab pressure, and notice what they're doing in response to your fireball patterns. Let's talk about his defense. Like we said, Space Bear is pretty good for walling them out. Same with Space Forward Air. Like, Mario doesn't have a lot of range, but these two are definitely the best.
And you like the retreating forward air a lot.
Yeah, this is definitely the Ganon. in terms of crouch canceling, we covered it earlier. Mario has one of the best crouch cancel games in the game. His crouch cancel grab is really good if they're close range because he gets really good follow ups on a grab. And crouch cancel down smash is pretty much good for everything else.
Yeah, it's really good if foxes are trying to nair. You could crouch cancel down smash their shit.
Oh yeah, any early nair pressure on Fox. If a Fox tries to early nair, you just crouch cancel down smash and it'll blow it up. Definitely really good. Okay, out of shield. Yeah, up tilt is pretty good as an anti-air.
Good for catching people. Up smash because the head is completely invincible and it catches people like from way more behind than they would expect.
Mm-hmm. So out of shield, like if somebody tries to cross up your shield, up smash is actually really good.
Hell yeah, up smash out of shield is one of my favorite things to use for when I'm getting pressured. And up B out of shield is also really good, but a little bit more risky because it leaves you in so much lag.
Is Nair out of shield any good?
Nair out of shield is good too, for sure. Because his aerials are so fast that in general his like Nair and up air out of shield will get people off you if mm-hmm. they're not spacing their pressure right.
Yeah, so any unsafe pressure or like rush down pressure on your shield, up smash, Nair, definitely really quick options you can go for. And up B.
Yeah, up B is even better if you have a platform up in.
Because Mario's wave dash out of shield is so good, like after you block an attack or reset, you can really easily engage or disengage with your opponent.
It's great to punish with a wave dash out of shield. So say I block an attack to get out.
That was the slowest wave dash out of shield.
Shut up.
Net play, Jones. All right, let's try again. But yeah, you can use it to punish some unsafe pressure, or even if I'm like trying to like box Gallo's shield down, like, and I'm just like throwing out aerials at this range, and he needs to wave dash back. He can do okay, just forward air out of shield. Just do that, Gallo. But the point is, wave dash back is also a pretty good option if I'm getting pressured right here. And you like to go for like pivot grab on people's approaches sometimes.
For sure,
right?
Especially foxes that like to nair.
I try it again. Oh, all right. Yeah, definitely caught me in my aerials. So yeah,
pivot grab it has more range than his regular standing grab. So sometimes you actually do want to go for it. Rather than his just regular grab, wave dash back grab or something.
Mm-hmm. And wave dash back grab is still a really good option. But yeah, wave dash back, still a really good option.
Sure.
Since his wave dash is so long, you can end up catching a lot of characters recklessly approaching.
And wave dash back forward smash is like the classic right now.
If I'm Fox, I'm coming in with a nair that easily gets blown up. So yeah, Mario definitely has his offensive game and his defensive game. A lot of mix-ups in terms of what he can do. So let's talk about his combo game a lot. It seems pretty simple, but I mean I can't get these combos, so
no, it would take you like a whole 2 minutes to learn them all. So people love playing Mario because his combos are actually so fun. That's what really drew me to the character myself. And then he has such a strong finisher with forward air that you get such a reward off of these long strings. So the main combo starter with Mario usually is the down throw. On a lot of characters, it will chain grab for a while, and it leads into his big combo strings, which get started with up tilt and up air. My favorite thing to do with up air is like reverse hit up air, because you will mix people up on their DI. They'll be trying to DI away from your up air, and they will get hit right into a position that leads into your forward air. But still, using reverse hitboxes will mix up your opponent no matter what, because in the heat of the brawl, you're going to be doing some stuff.
Yeah, so down throw and up tilt and down tilt are probably your best launchers.
Launching, yeah. Down tilt, not as good as it used to be, but it's still so quick that it will catch people. But if they are DIing away, full away, you won't be able to combo out of it.
Okay.
As of 3.6.
Yeah, and at this percent, I mean, you're not going to get a... follow up.
Definitely not on Mario.
Yeah.
All percents and for Mario combos, it's all about percents and what character you're comboing.
Yeah. For example, like down tilt at this percent might even combo a Spacey just because of how fast they fall.
Speaking of Spaceys, you actually want to up throw them instead of down throwing them, because you could up throw a chain grab them, and at higher percents, you could up throw to fair them to kill them.
Mm-hmm. So, in general, you want to be launching up with your down tilts, your down throws, and your up tilts, and then comboing across the stage with up air.
And then your finishers are forward air and forward smash, depending on how heavy the character is, where they end up from their combo DI.
The down smash is pretty good for a quick finisher, too.
Like, yeah, but it doesn't kill that early. That's the problem with it right now. As long as they're DIing, fine. Because, like, with bad DI, down smash will kill at about, like, 120 on the edge of this stage. And with good DI, it won't kill to, like, 150. As of 3.5, I want to say.
So how are you DIing this Mario down throw? Because you seem to get down throw forward air on me, but I can't get it on you.
Well, most people want to DI Mario's down throw behind him, especially slight DI behind, because that way, even if he does get the pivot, he won't be able to forward air you.
But really?
Slight DI behind means you can get the forward air if you just do a retreating forward air.
Huh.
So you'll hit them with your armpit.
Yeah, and, Ganon has an armpit hitbox too. It's pretty... good.
It feels great. But the easiest combo DI that people still do to this day that I love is when they DI straight in front of me, and I'm like, okay, that's the easiest way I could get a forward air on you at higher percents. Never DI a Mario down throw in front of them, because that's just, it makes it really easy for them. Always DI slight behind.
All right.
The last thing I want to talk about for combos are down airs when your opponent misses the tech on a platform are like the greatest thing for continuing shit, because it pops them up perfectly for more combos. And I want to see this in more Mario's play.
Yeah, that's actually super interesting. Oh! Ooh. Almost. Okay, there we go.
For every missed combo, you guys could just blame Netplay, don't worry.
Yeah! Gallo would never drop these in real life.
Yeah, never in a million years.
And that's the thing about Mario, like, the combos are that hard to land. So, like, if you practice enough with Mario, let's say, two minutes in the lab, You should be landing your throw into up air combos. Anyway. Ooh. Jeez, I'm killing myself after that. that was brutal. All right, let's get into edge guarding.
Right. Right. Another really, really strong asset for Mario is his edgeguard game.
Yeah, I just kind of back aired because back air is the...
Back air is your bread and butter.
Yeah.
Invincible back air. You grab the ledge, you get your invincibility frames, and then you back air. Simple. One of his staples is the cape, because it will not only reverse your opponent's momentum, but it will also reverse your opponent's controls for a short time.
Mm-hmm.
So you can really mix up people that way.
And if you want to go really aggro for edge guards, you do have one rising cape, so you can go out there.
And you even have your cape glide.
Yeah, you have fireballs to cover low recoveries and spacey recoveries.
Right.
This is the
spacey
angle.
Recoveries, you have down air, which is the main thing against spaceys, because you can do down air into things.
Yeah, I love covering this angle when a spacey is trying to recover, because they'll either side B or up B, and this like cuts their options in half.
Yep. Then if they're missing their sweet spot, you could angle down a forward tilt or a forward smash.
Yep.
And if you're edgeguarding a character like Sheik, per se.
Yeah, that lands up on the stage after.
You want to do like a ledge dash into down smash or a ledge dash into down tilt.
Yeah, it depends on the percent. Like if Sheik's at 40 or something, then you don't want to just down smash, or you can probably get like a full combo or something. But yeah, definitely don't let him just ledge dash into your full punish.
Right.
So that's pretty much Mario's edge guarding. Let's talk about his recovery, because his recovery is actually pretty good. His recovery and landing, like, so Mario's like coming down from like this range is not very good, but like when he's super high up, he has a lot of options. He has his cape, he has his B reverse pill, he has his down B.
Mm-hmm. But off stage, he's also just as strong.
Mm-hmm.
Off stage, he might be he has one of the best recoveries in the game, in my opinion, straight up.
Yeah, so many mix-ups.
Don't forget that he has one cape, one rising tornado, and an up B, and on walled stages, an up B wall jump. One thing I need to really let Mario mates know is you want to be down being as far away from the stage as possible, because there's so much end lag after down B. If you do that right next to the stage, you'll probably get punished.
I wanted to get the non-tipper. Alright, hit me far, I'll try to recover high. Yeah, that wasn't high enough, because I was too close to the stage, and if you down B too close to the stage as Mario, you're going to get punished. When you down B really far away, then you get to mix up your recovery a lot. Like, you can come down with pills and stuff, and,
Yeah, all right. Shooting pills at your opponent while they're trying to edgeguard you will just harass them so much.
Yeah, definitely. So you want to recover high and away from the stage, so you get the max amount of pills and the max amount of airtime. Mm-hmm. So you can.
And a good thing is using your down B before you use your double jump, because then you can use your double jump to get the height when you get close to the edge. Mario also has an up B wall jump on walled stages, and to do that, you have to be hugging the wall as Mario, not get edge guarded, and you have to press the opposite direction right as Mario is about to finish his up B.
I did it.
Yes, you did on your first freaking try.
I'm the best. I'm maining Mario now.
Might as well. I mean, that's basically as hard as Mario techs get. And it's really good because since his up B has invincibility from, I believe, frames 4 to 7, your opponent's not going to want to go challenge that. You can challenge the end, however. because he does get some lag after the wall jump. Oh, the main thing you want to be doing with Mario's movement and to mix people up is be reversing all your goddamn fireballs. Please use as much B reverse as possible because it's so good at getting him a lot of space to approach with. It gives him tons of mobility this way. You're also giving them your opponent another mix-up of the angle of the fireball, which way it's coming.
Yeah, and when you full hop like that with Mario, like, you're threatening the back air too. So like, when you're threatening the back air and then suddenly you're in their face with a fireball, it's actually pretty scary.
And you could also Waveland out of it.
So, oh, Waveland Fireballs. OP.
Yeah.
I'm trying.
Up B and up smash out of shield you want to learn for sure.
Yeah.
And one other thing that I guess it has some use is the Cape Glide. If you want to catch people off guard with that.
Alright.
So, Junebug, what did you learn today?
Well, Gallo, I didn't learn too much, but...
you don't have to when you're playing Mario.
Yeah, that's the thing. Mario is a pretty easy character to pick up. He has good aerials, good confirms off of throws, and good crouch cancels. Unfortunately, he does get crouch canceled at some earlier percents, and he kind of suffers from linear approaches. But that doesn't matter, because you can mix up his approaches really well. You have your really strong wave dash and movement, and mixed in with your fireball approaches and your aerial approaches, you can do a lot of crazy things to people's shield. You jab their shield, up tilt, after a fireball, jab grab, and then if people are trying to mix you up, you stay in shield and get grabbed. It's like...
And then you up smash them out of shield.
Yep. You up smash out of shield, wave dash back, down smash. Bunch of... Oh my god!
Yeah, that's the nation.
That's the nation. Shoutouts to nation.
Shoutouts to nation.
Yeah. His combos tend to start off of down throw into up air, and then forward airs and forward smash are like the finishers. Yeah, your up tilts, your down throws, and your up throws and your down tilts tend to be your launching moves. Your up airs are your combo extenders. And then...
also, reverse hit of back air can be your combo extender too.
Oh yeah. That's a pretty good move. And then you want to finish it off with a forward smash. Down smash. Forward smash and down smash are also really good spacing tools out of weight dash.
Yeah, because they come out so fast. Especially down smash.
So edge guarding, you want to use your back air and your fireballs and your cape. Of course, cape is really good for edge guarding anybody who has to up B like into you. Because they literally just get reversed.
Reverse.
Oh,
damn,
horrible.
Back throw kill.
The worst DI of all time. And his recovery has like 7 different components. You want to down B high, come down with pills, and oh wow, that sweet
and
spot.
And he has magnet hands too.
Yeah, magnet hands. And on stages with walls, you wall jump. Yeah, so that's Mario. Thanks for watching, everyone. Follow me on Twitter at ARJunebug. Follow Gallo on Twitter at Gallo Frequency. And any shoutouts you want to do, Gallo?
Shoutouts to the PM community. Guys, just keep playing the game. Keep coming out to tournaments. And I want to see you guys beating my Mario. Get better Marios than I am, because I'm a sorry excuse for Mario, guys. You can do better.
Yeah, everybody play Mario now. All right. Till next time. Peace.